By the way, you know, we've heard a number of things about Dhanuka. I agree. It's a company that's done very well. It manufactures herbicides and insecticides, etc. Strong return ratios, 25-30% ROCE, ROE. The stock is up 3%, has had a very good last couple of years. M.K. Dhanuka, MD of Dhanuka Agritech, joins us from New Delhi. Thanks so much for being very patient with us, Mr. Dhanuka. Thanks for being with us as well. Put this quarter into perspective. How has the quarter been? And how do you expect the next 12 months to be? Because a lot of people are talking about El Niño and clubbing all the agrarian companies as the ones which will do very well. How do you expect Dhanuka Agritech to do?
If it comes, definitely it will have some impact. But the companies who are present throughout India and having a vast range of pesticides for all kind of crops and all kind of pests and diseases, they will not be much impacted. But ultimately, monsoon is quite crucial for these ag chem companies. So if monsoon will be weak and El Niño will come, then the growth will be in the range of 15% instead of 25%.
You're talking about 25% growth for you as a company on the top line, or would that be the bottom line growth that you can show in FY15?
Top line will grow by 25%, and definitely the bottom line will be higher in comparison to the top line. It can be 30-35% in bottom line.
Question is, you've done very well the last 2 or 3 years, or probably even longer than that. Do you foresee that this 25 or 30 odd percent average growth that you're speaking about can last for the next 2 or 3 years, or is it too much to predict right now?
No. Actually, in India, we are consuming one of the lowest pesticides in the world, and our agriculture productivity is very low in comparison to even the neighboring country China. So if we have to increase the productivity, we cannot survive without increasing the consumption of pesticides. So I foresee that minimum 5 years this growth is sustainable, and since our company is bringing out 6 new molecules under section 9(3), which will be first time launched in India, 2 molecules every year, we are very confident that the growth of 25% in top line and 30-35% in bottom line, we will be able to achieve and deliver.
What about your debt burden? Any repayments that are coming up? How much do you think you can bring down your debt levels by?
Ours is a debt-free company. We don't have any debt on the company. Only working capital requirements from the bank for LC, and that is there. There is no debt on the balance sheet.
Still with us, Sandeep Pujanas on the other side. Also get in one more earnings call going on the other side.